Hey guys, what's up? Kane here, and this is another pickups video, and this is for the month of June, pretty much, 2012. Purchased a few games, PS3, actually all over the place, even a PC game, because I actually finally got a, see if I can show you real quick. My dog's over there, drinking water. Look at him. Anyway, I got a new PC. I got me a Alienware, I think it's X51, fully maxed. Using some old speakers there. I got a monitor with it too, but I've been wanting to PC game for a long time, and I've been out of PC gaming for a while, so finally went ahead and picked me up a PC, so pretty excited about that. Picked up some games on Steam like Jamestown and The Witcher and Yi's Origin, some games I really wanted to play. Which I won't have in this video, of course, because I usually don't talk about the games I download and buy, but I'm more about physical copy games anyway, unless they're really cheap, which stuff on Steam is really cheap. But kick things off, figure I'll show some of my E3 swag here. I got this little card here that came with something else that I got. It's a from the Atlas booth. It's pretty much they gave it with you when you went to pick up your badge, and it was little thing that talks about the arena and Persona 4 Golden that's coming out, which I'm really excited for. But it's also a pass for a free t-shirt. And luckily, I got a medium. They had my size, and I wanted this shirt really bad. And I tried to get in touch with Atlas to see if they could sell me one, but they wouldn't. So my only option was eBay. So, but I was able to get one for pretty decent, pretty cheap price. I didn't want to pay, you know, a lot for it, but I picked that up. Haven't worn it or anything. I don't even know if I will. Probably will though. It's a really nice looking shirt. Next up, I was just all about Persona 4 for some reason. I just love the art style and everything with the game. I picked up a couple weeks ago Famitsu magazine, and it had Persona 4 Golden on the front, which is pretty cool. Some good articles in it as well, and it had Arena on the back. But I just love the cover a lot and the way it looked, so I bought it. These magazines aren't really that expensive, like $10, so I picked that up. Alright, on to the games. First up, a PS1 game I picked up, and this is the game I wanted for a while, and I got it for, I think, $2.25, and that's SD Gundam G Generation Zero for the PlayStation 1. And this is another one of those SD Generation games, but this is an older game, so it's more 2D side-scrolling RPG, and it comes with some cards here, which is really cool. And of course, I always gotta have the manual and everything, but it also comes with the spine card, which I really like a lot. And I haven't really played this yet because I've been really busy with work and other things I've been doing. But it's three discs. I'm really surprised the game's three discs. It's crazy, but I didn't know if one was a soundtrack or not. I'll have to look into it. But I bought it on the fly and I wanted it, so I picked it up. Next up, some PS2 games I picked up, and this actually will complete my collection on SD G Generation Gundam games on the PS2. I have all of them now. First one I picked up is SD G Generation's Neo. I also picked up SD G Generation's Seed. Really love Gundam Seed. Next is another one. I'm not sure if it's made by the same company, but it's actually a little bit different. This one is a Mobile Suit Gundam Gundam Seed Destiny Generation CE. Now this is made by the same company, but instead of the Gundams being super deformed, they're actual life size like they are in the anime, so which is really cool. So I picked that up as well, and it expands the whole timeline, CE timeline, even the manga. So really happy to have that. Next up, also picked up SD Gundam G Generation Spirits. It's awesome. And then the last PS2 game I picked up, which is actually not an import, and that is Nightmare of Dragoa, which is based on the classic arcade game by Namco. I've been wanting this game for a long time, ever since it came out, and finally I just splurged and picked it up since it was $5. So, pretty cool looking artwork on the front. The arcade game is pretty classic too. I believe they ported it to the TurboGrafx as well, if I'm not mistaken, but it might have just been the PC Engine Japanese version. I can't remember. Alright, next up, I picked up picked up one PSP game, surprisingly, and that is, I think it's called Gundam by Atlas. I haven't really read much about this game. I know it's developed by Steam. It looks really awesome. Hope to get around to eventually playing it, but I had to grab it because these PSP games are getting harder and harder to find, especially new ones. They release them in very limited quantities, but I went ahead and picked that up. A lot of GameStops don't even carry PSP games anymore, so it's really hard to get a hold to them. Alright, next up is a DS game. I picked up one DS game, and actually I haven't had a chance to play it, but my friends and my nephews played it, and I'm really excited to get around to playing it. And that is Pokemon Conquest. Now, I originally just picked this up because I really don't care too much for Pokemon. The only Pokemon game I ever played was the one on the original Game Boy. A long time ago. I can't remember what it was called. But this one right here is mixed with Techno Koi, and they're pretty much their, you know, Oda Nobunaga or Samurai Warriors series. And they mashed it together and made a tactical RPG, and it looks really, really, really good. I was watching my friend play it Monday, and I was really impressed by it, and I can't wait to dive in and play it. The reason it's open is, like I said, my nephews was here yesterday, and he wanted to play it, so I let him play it for a while before his mother came and picked him up. So yeah, pretty cool looking game. Definitely worth picking up for $34. It looks really, really fun. I can't wait to actually play it because I'm a big fan of RPGs and just the whole Feudal Japan era and fighting over Japan, and to add that with the Pokemon. It's kind of a cool little way to get other people who haven't played Pokemon games into playing Pokemon, as well as Pokemon fans playing something a little different outside the norm of the standard Pokemon games. So, can't wait to play that. Alright, next up is my first PC game that I picked up in a long time. My friend recommended this to me, and I remember playing the first one a long time ago, and I really loved it. And that is Total War Shogun 2. This is the limited edition version, which has the ninja clans, it has the Battle of Nagashino, and a bunch of other extra stuff. It actually has the ninja clan is the Hattori clan, is in Hattori Hanzo, I believe. But just a great, great game. Very, very time consuming though. I wish I had more time to play this game, but I noticed playing the game, it takes a lot of time to play one of these games. This is one of them games is if like you're the type of person who's tight on money and don't like to buy a lot of games, and you just want to find one game to last you a couple months. Yeah, Total War Shogun 2 would definitely last you that long, if not a year. It's just so massively in depth. And I actually can't believe just how well it looks as far as like the detail, because you can actually, you expand out and you control your whole army, but you can actually zoom in so close that you can see each individual character. They're fully animated. They act on their own. It's really impressive. And I actually downloaded the blood pack for $1.59 to add blood, and it makes it look even more spectacular. And I definitely recommend it. If you love RPGs or real-time strategy, this game is amazing. It has everything you would want. And like I said, being a huge Japanese Feudal Japan fan, I had to get it, and I'm not disappointed. This game is amazing. And for $30, it's totally worth it. Alright, next up, I picked up some PS3 games. And the first game I picked up is something I had to have. After meeting Suda51 at PAX East, got his autograph, and sort of talked to him a little bit. He doesn't really speak very good English, but really great guy, nice guy. And I picked up a Lollipop Chainsaw. And I've already beat it, actually. It's a very short game, but it's very fun, very humorous, great music. You know, classic Devil May Cry type game. Actually, to be more specific, it's like No More Heroes, really, which he made that game as well. It's just, if you like No More Heroes, you'll love this game. This game's fun, over the top, straight Japanese. I mean, it's really great, really fun. Like I said, the game's short, but there's a lot of replay value if you want to go through, unlock everything, beat your rank, trophies, things like that. You could probably beat the game in about 6 hours. I think it's about how long it took me to beat, maybe shorter. But still worth the $60. Gotta support these very niche Japanese companies and help them get on the map, because games like this are a dying breed, and it's really nice to see something unique like this come about. Very humorous, very funny. I'm not sure how to put the humor. It's it's out there. They talk about very vulgar things and stuff, and it's pretty funny. A lot of innuendos and things like that. Definitely worth playing, definitely worth checking out. If you know me, it takes me a while to play video games. Usually I buy games and don't even open them, but I actually opened that and played it and beat it. And put Tales of Graces and Dragon Dogma aside and played that, and it was really fun. Another game I picked up is Rune Factory Tides of Destiny, and I believe this is probably the third one in the series. This game's actually pretty fun. The intro was really boring though. I mean, the intro took about 30 minutes, but it looks like a really cool little game, and I can't wait to play it. I've never been a fan of Harvest Moon or any of those types of games, so this will be my first time into the series. So I look forward to playing this game and seeing what it's all about, and seeing if it'll make me want to go back and play some of those older style games. But so far, like I said, it seems pretty good. The voice acting is actually pretty good. The only downside is the intro took forever. I understand it's got to explain everything to you and how to do things, but I mean, it was like a 40-minute slugfest. It just was just like it was so slow. But other than that, I can't wait to play it. And yeah, Rune Factory, Tides of Destiny. Alright, next up is two games that actually I already have, but I have collector's edition versions of them, and I don't want to open them because they became a little bit more up in value. These were $20, so I rebought them, and that is Atelier Verona. And I actually played this for about an hour to 2 hours, and it was really fun, really enjoyable. The voice acting is actually pretty good. And this looks like a game that I'll get very addicted to. When I was just playing the, I put it in, my friend was over, and I put it in, I was like, let's see what this game's about. I've never played an Atelier game, even though I own every one of them that's been released. And I put it in, and I was playing it, and I was like, man, I gotta stop playing this game. This game's just a type of game that I will get addicted to, and I will not finish the other games I'm playing at the moment. So I had to put this one to the side, but I can't wait to come back and play it. Very beautiful art style, very, very great music, and just, you know, niche JRPG, and if you like animes and stuff, you'll really appreciate it. It's just got that kind of that voice acting and dialogue, and just looks really awesome. Can't wait to play it. And now that brings me to my next one, Atelier. I hope I'm saying this right. Tatori. This was the one that really got me excited about the whole series, because this one looks phenomenal as far as graphics and stuff go. Have yet the chance to put it in and play it, but again, I bought it for $20. I thought it was a pretty good deal. And it's going to eventually become very hard to find. But I had to have it, and I can't wait to play it. Which, again, leads me to this game that came out this month. And that is Atelier, I think it's Meruru. And this is The Apprentice of Arlen. And this is the final one in the Arlen story arc. And this is the limited edition that was only available off NIS America Store, which comes with a bunch of stuff, soundtrack, art book, actually comes with a really big t-shirt which says Barrel on it, which is kind of cool. Not much to say here. I haven't played it or opened it. I just knew it was going to be a little collector's piece. Probably never open it. But yeah, I had to have it in the collection, so I picked it up. I had all the other ones. Might as well get that one. Alright, next up, I picked up one Wii game, and I got this for $10. And this game is notoriously known for having some of the worst voice acting ever, and that's Arcrise Fantasia. Now, if you YouTube some footage of this game, you'll see the voice acting is atrocious. It's so bad, it's funny. But I was told from a good friend that this game is amazing. He said if you play through the game and with the voice acting off, it actually gives you an option to turn the voice acting off. Play through it straight, voice acting off, you'll really enjoy the game. It's really good. So what I'm thinking about doing is doing exactly what he said. Though it's kind of hard not to resist listening to the voice acting because it's so bad. So bad. It's really, really bad. I'm surprised at how bad it is. I know voice acting back in the day would be really bad, but modern day games, usually the voice acting isn't that terrible, but it's rough, I tell you. But it's so bad, it's funny. I could play through it probably with the voice acting on and just chuckle and laugh. But yeah, picked this up. Glad to have it in the collection. Can't wait to get around and play it. Bad thing about RPGs, they take forever to play. Alright, last on my big list of games I picked up this month is a game that I've actually already bought. I just didn't cancel the subscription. I don't know why, it's just how I am, but I picked up Disgaea 3, Absence of Detention. Yes, this is my second copy. I'll probably end up selling it or something. I really don't need two copies. But I had to get it from the NIS store because it came with this limited edition cloth chamois microfiber tally thing. I'm not sure what you'd call it. But it came with that. It's really cool. I guess you could use it to clean off your screen of your Vita or something, but I'll probably never open it, but it came with that. So it was the only way to get it, so I went ahead and grabbed it. I was hoping it was going to be bundled in the game and then I could just keep it sealed, but it's not. So I might throw this game up and sell it. I don't know. Anyway, that's it for the games that I picked up for the month of July, guys. Awesome. Yeah. Have a good one.